Hey guys, I found some obvious symbolism that the Grokks has been pointing out for years and years, just in some stuff he hasn't seen yet. I mean, everywhere, it's everywhere. So I mean, the Grokks isn't going to be posting every single thing. So I try and help him out in stuff he's probably not seen or just things I haven't seen him say yet. Obviously, Maroon 5, the 5 is for the fifth age of the Book of Daniel. That's when the iron is mixed with the clay, the metal with flesh, some kind of DNA transformation when all this New World Order happens. So Maroon 5, the cover, has a big V on it to represent that. It's also red, showing the time of red coming back. Right now it's mercy and grace. You see California's kind of blue, but then the red comes down, brings down the red side. I mean, all the red flags literally are Islam, North Korea, the red coats of England, China, Russia. I mean, everything is red. They're going to invade America, which is mostly Christians. Okay, and the big explosion is actually supposed to cover up the amount of Christians who are raptured during it. The Grokks has told us that, so, and that makes perfect sense. Anyway, the song Animals, I couldn't even watch the whole video. It was just so gross. I mean, it's literally him wanting to stalk this girl and kind of just, use her as a piece of meat. He is literally the butcher, just like the butcher coming, as in Jesus is the baker, the bread of life, but Satan, who goes by the law and sin and judgment, is the butcher who kills. Since technically the wages of sin are death, that means, if you sin, you have to die, like Islam and the Jews believe. No matter what they say, that's what their Bible believes. And if they don't believe their Bible, then they aren't true Muslims or Jews. But anyway, so this just represents the butcher coming, attacking the woman. Revelation 12 is about the dragon persecuting the woman during the fifth age when he is cast down finally. It's like a bull horns, like the devil, literally, okay? I mean, you can watch the video. I wouldn't. I mean, I couldn't even finish it, Anyway, on to Gears of War. This video game. Okay, fact one. His name is Phoenix. So he's trying to stop this alien invasion once again, just like every single thing ever. So his name is Marcus Phoenix. Phoenix, actually, like, mark us, the mark of the beast. You either get the mark of the beast or you're on the wings of an eagle, the phoenix, rapture. So his name symbolizes both options. And actually, they have to fight what is called the locusts. They have to fight, that's exactly in Revelation. Out of the black pit, or out of the bottomless pit, and the smoke came locusts, and they ruled upon the earth like the scorpions rule on the earth. Look at them. I mean, they're kind of demonic, somewhat reptilian-like, okay? And there's even a little football scene, and the guy's number is 83, just like Psalm 83, which is the great war at the end times, just like Ezekiel 38, which is also the end war, the end times war, and you just switch the numbers right there. But anyway, he was the Cougars going against the Eagles. Actually, he was the Panthers, like the leopard of Daniel, representing Obama. He was on the Cougars. He just happens to be black, like Obama. I don't know if that's coincidence or Illuminati symbolism. But he was on the Cougars, and they went against the Eagles. So you're either deceived by Obama, the leopard, or you're on the eagle side. That's why Philadelphia is the only church in Revelation 3 to be raptured, the only one of the seven churches to be raptured. That's why it's the Philadelphia Eagles football team. Once again, that's the Grokst. Anyway, of course, later on in the game in Gears of War 3, there's a zombie apocalypse. These kind of new aliens have this yellow type thing in their bodies, and they explode when they die. But it's also infecting humans near the end of Gears of War 3. Okay? I bought this game for about $2 the other day, and I'm almost done with it. So, I mean, it's the symbolism, and I knew it would be there. It's always there. Same thing, different story. He has the wings of an eagle on him because his name is Phoenix, Marcus Phoenix. And then he has to fight the locusts in Revelation. And it represents the great war of Ezekiel 38 and Psalm 83. And then at the end is the even bigger zombie apocalypse, okay? It's the same symbolism, different video games, okay? The only way to escape this new world order is to believe in Jesus, believe in mercy, have mercy on your brothers and sisters. Don't judge them. It's not even your job. Like Tupac said, only God can judge me. So if you're judging other people, I mean, you're playing God. And that's not what it's all about. It's about forgiving them because you know you're only human, so that means they are only human. Okay, so if you don't have mercy, you're going to receive the judgment. The wrath of the Lamb is some zombie apocalypse, straight up. Okay, thank you.